This is going to be an honest and raw video where I share a lot of realistic insight into what goes on behind the lens. This is insight I get by running a YouTube bootcamp for women, running and managing several YouTube channels, coaching women YouTube creators, and personally being friends with a lot of very successful YouTubers. All day of my day, every day, is pretty much spent talking to YouTube creators and dissecting and studying the platform. And I'm gonna be revealing some hard truths that you don't hear too many people talk about in the YouTube marketing space, but they're conversations that happen all the time amongst the creator community, especially amongst full-time YouTube influencers. And if you're new to this community, or you're thinking of starting a YouTube channel, or you wanna eventually be a full-time YouTuber, or you just want some more insight into just life as a creator, then the thing that I'm going to talk about in this video, you're going to want to learn about and be aware of before jumping all in. Number one, YouTube isn't for everyone. So let me ask you this. Does getting in front of a camera scare you? Does the thought of creating content absolutely like freak you out? Would you rather do anything other than create video content? Or another question is, do you have something unique, special, or interesting that you think people that don't know you, absolute strangers, will be willing to stop what they're doing in that moment and watch? It's really important to consider the answers to these questions and a lot more if you're serious about doing YouTube. You have to remember that YouTube is a visual medium, and having a personality that's approachable, engaging, interesting, endearing is essential to seeing some success. At the same time, having a strong opinion or mission behind your content is also essential to success, as well as understanding the tech and marketing that's all involved, all these things that are involved with being successful on YouTube. Some of these things that I just mentioned, people don't think about. They see a girl sitting on her bed discussing her favorite products, or another mom showing what's in her hospital bag. They think, that's so easy. Oh my God, I can't believe they make money doing that. I can do that. And then they jump right in, that they see all these other people on YouTube doing it, and they assume that they'll have that same success. But the truth is, YouTube isn't necessarily the best platform for everyone. A successful YouTuber needs to embody all of these traits and more. I do believe that if you really want to be successful on YouTube, you can refine and train those traits or talents that aren't there. But without the willingness to do this, or even awareness that that's missing, it'll be difficult to grow. Not everybody has the natural camera presence, the technical know-how, and marketing intuition that are all requirements to be successful on YouTube. So how do you know? How do you know if you're missing any of these? The only way to really know is to try it for yourself, is to get out there, get your feet wet, and see what happens. See where you shine, see where you don't, see what you enjoy doing, see what you don't enjoy doing, and make the decision that you're either gonna work on improving those skills that are lacking in order to compete with the other YouTubers, or do something else. Find another platform that might be a better fit for your talents. Or another option is, if you have the means, to hire somebody who's better suited with those talents that you lack and focus on what you enjoy doing as part of the process. I know a lot of creators personally that, for example, they don't have that marketing intuition. They're incredible creators, or they're incredibly talented and they have something really cool to share on video, but they don't seem to understand the nuances of creating a killer thumbnail and title. So they improve those skills. They take courses, they study other channels, and over time they improve. Or they hire someone like me to do it for them. And if you're looking for that, I do offer one-on-one coaching and channel management. All the info for that's in the description. But on the opposite spectrum, I know people that instinctively understand that marketing. They instinctively understand what it takes to hook a viewer with the right thumbnail and title, with the right video topic, but they're terrible at the tech or the editing. So they either hire that out or they learn that skill. But not everyone has to have a YouTube channel, and that's okay. However, though, if there's an intuition inside of you bugging you to try it, then for sure give it a shot. And it could definitely work, as it has for many others, and really be something truly, truly life-changing. I mean, YouTube has completely changed my life and many, many of the people that have gone through my bootcamp and then I work with personally. But you'll figure out really quick where your weaknesses are and if you actually want to invest the time and resources to improve them. Number two, YouTube viewers don't care about you until you prove yourself to them. This is one of those hard truths that if you really understand what I'm trying to tell you here, you will be ahead of 95% of YouTube creators out there. So people watch their favorite YouTuber chat about their day in their life, or they watch them get ready and they turn around and think, I can do that. That is so easy. I make a smoothie every morning and mine has really good ingredients, or I love my makeup routine. Everyone's gonna wanna know about it. This looks so easy. I'll just make these videos about my life, about my smoothie. But what a lot of people don't grasp is that a lot of the YouTubers that you're watching have a lot of subscribers, or they've been doing it for a really long time. And this audience will tune into them no matter what they do, because they've already proven themselves to their audience in one way, shape, or form. Or they've been on the platform forever and they've always done these types of videos. And back in the day when they first started, there was way less competition and just a lot less creators on the platform. So really, no matter what you did, you were able to build an audience and stand out. Or maybe the person you're watching is really unique. Their occupation, their lifestyle, something about them is truly different that sets them apart. Or maybe they have an incredible skill set like editing or filmmaking that can turn mundane content into something watchable. Like Peter McKinnon, he blew onto the scene, but he was an incredibly talented filmmaker. He knew all these different techniques on how to film, and it blew up his channel. So you need to think about the fact that people don't know you, they don't care about you, and they don't even like you yet. I know it's hard to hear, but you really, 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 really gotta let that sink in. But what will get people to care? What will get people to like you? If you give them something of value. That could be entertainment. It could be advice. It could be some insight. It could be a peek into an unusual world. But it needs to be something that they want. In my free YouTube masterclass, which I will link right here, I teach about magnetic content and the four magnetic content categories. And I'll give you the quick cliff notes, but definitely check out that class because there's a lot of valuable information on it. It's about an hour, and there's a whole workbook that goes along with it. But magnetic content must be one of these four following traits: curiosity, need, deep desire, and pain point. So you want to make sure that your content includes one of those traits to make magnetic and to be that valuable content that people are going to want to watch. Number three, YouTube success takes work and doesn't generate passive income. I've said this before on this channel, and I go into more detail about it here in this video, so I will link that below and in the card, so make sure you check that out as well. But YouTube is a platform that has incredible opportunities for success. I truly believe that. I wouldn't be here at this time right now talking to you. But at the same time, it does require a big, big commitment. It's not like a side hustle, little hobby level of commitment. Most of the people I know that have decently successful channels to very successful channels are putting in a huge amount of energy, resources, money, and time into making their YouTube channel work. I think that a lot of people have been taught, or they think that if you follow an easy 1-2-3 formula and you now have this passive income stream coming in, making money while you sleep. No. That is not the case at all when it comes to YouTube. In fact, I don't know a single successful YouTube creator who can honestly say that that's the reality. And if someone is telling you otherwise, they're lying, or they're trying to sell you something, or they really aren't doing anything, but they have a huge team behind them that is doing all the work. So can you generate passive income? It depends on how you define passive. Passive to me is literally not doing a single thing and checking your bank account every so often and seeing it grow. That's passive. With YouTube and most passive income opportunities, let's be honest, it doesn't happen like that. You're needing to constantly create content. content. That's where the whole consistency thing comes in. In fact, that's the case for all influencers, no matter what platform you're on, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook. Making the decision to start a YouTube channel should really be something that you think long and hard about. And decide if you're actually ready to make a commitment it actually takes to see results. This is Editing Erica, and I want to make sure I clarify this point of passive income. So a lot of people get into YouTube thinking that if I create a bunch of videos, then I'm going to be making AdSense money while I sleep. I'll be making money from affiliates while I sleep. I'll be making money from brand deals while I sleep. While that's true, the point in time where you're actually able to generate an income that's actually substantial enough to support you, it requires a tremendous amount of work to get there. And that's the beauty of YouTube, is that the amount of work that you do can bring you an ROI for months or even years on end. The more videos you have out there, the more those videos are getting picked up by the algorithm. But still, it doesn't come without being consistent or putting all of that consistency into play and uploading and having a commitment to creating content consistently. What happens is that you're still doing work, but the idea is you're doing the same amount of work, but you're making more money. But you're still doing work. It's not passive.
I talk about this more in this video, so I highly suggest you check that out as well. And if you're not willing to put in the blood, sweat, or tears, then having a YouTube channel will probably be a huge, huge waste of time and money for you, because you're gonna be competing against a lot of people who actually are willing to put in the blood, sweat, and tears to create the best content possible for the audience. Number one, YouTube isn't for everyone and it might not be for you. Number two, people don't care about you until you prove yourself to them. And then number three, YouTube success takes a lot of work and, contrary to popular belief, doesn't generate passive income. Do I think YouTube is a right opportunity for the right person? Absolutely, which is why I do what I do. And I'm here right now making this video for you. But I always want to be realistic and share the honest truth about the road to one of the best online opportunities right now. So just consider me your truth teller when it comes to the real reality of YouTube. And if you want more of this, then make sure you subscribe, because I come out with new content every single week. And check out the recommended videos that I have for you in the description to catch yourself up if you're new. Let me know in the comments, what are your thoughts? Do any of these three truths surprise you? Or did you learn it the hard way? I want to know. And I'll see you in the next video. Mwah.